Recycling is something British people are pretty keen on. 87% of households say they do it regularly, and more packaging and products than ever are recyclable. But despite this, England missed its national target of recycling 50% of its waste by 2020, as rates stalled at 45% in 2017. Yet, something worse appears to be happening. Across Britain, around 11% of everything put out for recycling is actually being incinerated. So, why are we burning our recycling? The first thing we need to understand is recycling is run by local councils, and each has its own rules. So depending on where you live, you might not have the same collections as your neighbouring council. When your waste is taken away, the recycling gets sorted into what can be recycled and the stuff that can't. Out of all the different recycling, there's one material that releases more CO2 from incineration than coal, and that's plastic. The plastic that can be recycled is sorted by type. Then it gets shredded before being melted back into pellets and sold. The plastic that can't be recycled either goes to landfill or is incinerated. In 2020, 486,000 tons of plastic were recycled in the UK, but a further 688,000 tons were exported out of the UK for recycling, at which point we have no control over what happens to it.
Plastic waste from Britain that's supposed to be sent to Turkey for recycling is instead being dumped there and in some cases burnt.
It's estimated that 60% of what goes into Britain's waste incinerators is recyclable, because many local authorities in England are failing to recycle properly, with London and the North East being the worst offenders. So why is this happening? Councils face two big problems that combine to make incinerating recycling the attractive option. The first problem is that many councils have taken out long-term incineration contracts to burn their waste and create electricity. This started in the 1990s, when councils moved away from dumping waste in landfill, which creates methane, a greenhouse gas that's 25 times more damaging than CO2. The second problem is that recycling takes labour, and more than 10 years of austerity has left councils short-staffed and without money. As a result, a lot of stuff that could be recycled gets burned instead, because it's more cost-effective to just add recycling to the general waste. The waste disposal industry defends incineration by saying that over the last two decades it's reduced CO2 emissions by diverting rubbish away from landfill and generating electricity. But in 2019, waste incineration added 13% more greenhouse gases to emissions associated with electricity generation, but only contributed 2.4% of the UK's electricity. What's worse, the CO2 numbers reported for waste incineration is only required to include plastic, not all the other recycling that gets burned with it. So CO2 emissions for incineration are most likely even higher than reported. So how do we start to fix this? One option would be to tax incineration, as we have with landfill, to break our reliance on burning our rubbish. Another option could be to suspend all new waste incinerators, as the Welsh Government did in 2021. Wales has the third best household recycling rate in the world and only incinerates 24% of its rubbish. Unlike England, Wales employs a consistent collection scheme countrywide. Or we could even follow something like the French solution. To back up their ban on plastic straws, cups, cutlery and polystyrene takeaway boxes, France banned plastic packaging on most fruit and vegetables from the 1st of January 2022. Whereas, here in the UK, we currently produce 99 kilos of plastic waste per person per year. And that's the second highest in the world, behind the USA.